It starts with an idea.
Oh, this piece will be good. Working in any art field is sort of a meditative experience. So you have the idea. Who knows where the ideas come from? They just happen.
Add in a little sawing, torching, and hammering. And before you know it, those ideas come to life. These copper armadillos, necklaces, and bracelets, just some of the pieces metalsmith instructor and artist Sarah Gross churns out here in her Vancouver studio. The former ecologist selling her one-of-a-kind pieces throughout the Lower Mainland for the past 15 years.
People used to not think of copper as something they would want in jewelry at all, and people seem to be more willing to accept copper. It does interesting things when you expose it to different materials. You get some interesting colors, and it's very three-dimensional. Working in three dimensions is much more interesting to me.
With a jewelry maker today making a set of her popular copper earrings.
I transfer the design to the copper, then I cut it out, file it.
Sarah then heating up the mined material in order to make it bend. With a full-time artisan also selling her work in various local shows, including Britannia Mine Museum's recent Copper and Fire art exhibit, Sarah is among the growing number of artists dedicated to showcasing the beauty and versatility of this once solely industrial product.
It's a great show because it's actually in a mine site which was one of the world's biggest producers of copper for many, many years. And so I think people like it because they get to see not only how the resource extraction worked, but then they get to see a whole range of products. The traditional way is something called sinclastic raising. So this bowl is an example of sinclastic raising, where you take a piece of metal and you hammer it and you compress the sides and you get some kind of cup or bowl-shaped form.
Along with detergent solutions, Sarah also mixes her metal with fruits, veggies, and plants, including spinach and mushrooms, to bring out copper's signature red and gold tones, with some foods changing its color completely.
A lot of foods are somewhat acidic, and so they do react with copper and brass, which is an alloy of copper. So now I've tried about 90 different things.
With a copper lover always on the lookout, continually scouring metal yards and other downtown spots for her next material, it's this sense of adventure, creativity, and ability to escape from the rest of the world that continues to drive the lifelong artist. Having people actually display and wear her designs, well, that's just a bonus.
I like the idea of creating something that first somehow you're either inspired by something you see or something that happens, or it's some idea that just pops into your head. The time usually just flies by. If it wasn't for my dog, who likes to be fed and likes to go for walks, I would be here much, much longer. And there you go.